Welcome back to the very first episode of the brand new season of The Cursed Checkpoint from HorribleNight.com, our topical podcast. I'm your host, Justin Lacey. This is coming at you live on Tuesday, March 11th, 2014, on Twitch.tv/HorribleNight. My guest tonight, Mr. Aaron McNeil. How's it going, Aaron?
I'm here for loot, to talk about loot, to make loot, to sell it, but the auction house is closed.
Thank God. That's the best thing to happen in a long time.
That's the best news.
So, why are you playing Diablo 3 right now? This is, what, exactly 2 weeks before the expansion comes out. But why are you playing right now?
Yeah, I'm playing right now because Loot 2.0 is live. And that seems like a good time to see what kind of loot drops when you kill things.
Like, yeah, what about Loot 2.0 made you excited?
Well, at first I had a friend and he was playing and he's like, hey, Loot 2.0 is live and, you know, you're getting good loot finally. It's the way Diablo 3 should have been from the start. And I'm like, oh, okay, yeah, whatever. And so I jumped on and holy crap, did Blizzard do a great job of making your previous build, you know, prior to Loot 2.0 so inadequate. My first hour was almost the worst.
Were you getting the shit beat out of you?
Yeah, I was taking damage. I was down in my health potions like crazy, which is good that they made them just one item.
Yeah, so I heard those kind of nightmare stories that you would come back and you're kind of underpowered until you get those first few drops, and then there's like this big spike in loot quality because
definitely.
You know, you liked some Diablo 3 when it came out, right? Like we weren't too put off by it, but we weren't. I don't know. Beyond that first rush, we weren't really hooked into the game. And I think case in point, I played all the way to the beginning of Act 4, and I stopped playing, and I don't really know why. But
wow.
Kind of looking back on it, like I got excited for Diablo 3 when Ethan wrote his article and walked me through, I don't want to read these bullet points. Tell me what Loot 2.0 is. Like, should I care?
Basically, yeah.
Because it helped put into my mind what my problem with Diablo 3 originally was like, yeah, it was kind of cool. Anytime you'd kill dudes in Diablo 3, it would just shower loot all over your face. But it was all grays and whites and just worthless pieces of shit.
Garbage. And
none of it was exciting. I was just using it to, you know, my primary means of improving my character was to salvage all that stuff and hopefully, like, build the next great item, but everybody kind of had those items, so I just never had that, like, that loot excitement, and
same here.
It was kind of a bummer, but so
it was a real bummer.
But it took a while. Like, I was so into the just playing it, I didn't really notice that until the grind really started to hit me. So I put the game down for forever. Thought I wouldn't come back, and we'll talk about some other games and as to why. But what excited me about, well, for when I started hearing those stories about if you're going to jump back in the game, you're going to be underpowered for a while. I was like, you know what? On a whim here, while I'm just getting back in this game, let's just delete all my characters.
That's what you did.
So I did that, and I've started over my Demon Hunter, and I've started over a Barbarian. And, yeah, already got some legendary loot, like, right out of the gate. And,
oh, seriously?
You know, like, whenever you pick up an item you're excited about, you should be able to notice its impact. And that's the difference with Loot 2.0. Like, it doesn't shower you with loot, but, like, when it does drop, it's you have a decision to make. Like, it's either going to be drastically better or slightly better. And if I can notice it, and it looks cool, and two, it's making an impact as I'm killing dudes, that's really all I care about. So,
that's a good point, because I think that basically sums up why I put so many hours into it, like the last two weekends. It's just the fact that now it's not just a bunch of whites and, you know, magic, and they're pretty boring, and you're like, oh, I'm hitting stuff, but I don't really care about why I'm hitting stuff. But the oranges just explode out of things every now and then. I'm like, oh, what's this? And I'm genuinely excited, and I could feel the impact that I'm making on fighting these enemies, and I'm like, oh,
like the it helps with that sense of progress, and that's what you feed my loot hunger. I'm going to keep playing, and for whatever reason, you know, there's been some good releases lately that I really want to play, but I'm thirsty for Diablo right now. And it, for me, I don't know if it's the case for you, I don't really care about Reaper of Souls. I'm going to get it. I'm going to play it just so I have more to play. But that's not, I came back for Loot 2.0. I didn't come back for Reaper of Souls.
I feel that's the same way for me. Like, I'm really kind of dedicated to my wizard right now. I haven't gotten any characters to level 60. My wizard's like 52 right now. So I'm like, I got to get to 60, start getting those Paragon points.
Yeah.
But I don't really care about starting over the Crusader. I don't know anything about Act 5. The story in Diablo 3 was the last reason why I played Diablo 3.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I could care. It's funny. I really like the atmosphere of Diablo, of the Diablo universe, but could care less about the details of the story. I was like, what demon am I killing next? Who, like, where am I going? Like, this looks a little different than the last area. That's good. So,
point me to that loot demon.
You know, how do these new bodies, how are their ragdoll physics when I explode them into the air? Like, is that
pretty good? Great. I love killing enemies and then accidentally launching like a meteor comet like straight into their dead corpses and then bodies fly everywhere and I'm like, overkill, but you know, maybe there's more loot inside.
Gotta bump up those physics. So right now they're also doing, I think this runs up until the expansion comes out, but the whole 50% bonus to your experience.
Yeah.
That's the other reason I started over, is because I knew I could, I've already got, and probably only 6 hours of playing, I almost have a level 20 already. And I was only at level 31. So I'm going to try to like get at least a level 20 across every character class just so I'm ready to go. I'm not sure what I want to stick with. I really like my Demon Hunter. I really like playing the Barbarian because he just beats the shit out of people. I'm curious. I'm curious at how the Crusader will feel because he seems kind of interesting. But
yeah, I'm wondering if the Crusader will be like the defensive version of the Barbarian in that case, which I don't know. It seems like in Diablo, at least in Diablo 3, attack is where you want to be. So I'm curious if the Crusader will just be, will the Crusader be defensive or will it just be like holy magic attack?
Yeah, will he be more of a meat shield and he can take a lot of damage but doesn't really, like, I like the Barbarian when he explodes dudes. And that's really, that's what it's all about. So,
gems.
And so, I don't know if the Crusader will have to have some of that, but will it feel different than the Barbarian? So, I'll have to figure that out.
Mysteries.
Ghost in chat. Yeah, we don't have any level 60s. I think a couple of our guys on the site, I think Ethan has a 60, but he's been going back and leveling up other characters. But the Paragon levels, I've heard good things about them as far as just adding additional attributes to your character after you've hit the max level, giving you a reason to keep playing and improve them and seeing some improvements to them. So that should be interesting too. And I'm excited about adventure mode. I think that's all I care about is Loot 2.0 and adventure mode. So
same here.
Just give me some new area and some like little carrot of a quest to go mess around with. And I'll click away to until everything is dead and I look really shiny.
So I think, I don't know if it's part of adventure mode, but there's like the whole idea of dungeons now. Like you'll generate some dungeons, you'll get tickets, and you can go in there and kind of just raid a dungeon and get some good 2.0 loot and legendaries out of it. And that seems really interesting, especially as a person that's already run through, you know, acts 1 through 4, and I'm sure 5 will only take, you know, a couple hours maybe to get through. And then the idea of these dungeons seems like a good kind of, you know, that carrot we're talking about to just keep going to get that loot until we get bored again.
Sure. And I guess that's kind of my question. Do you still think, I'm on a Diablo 3 hype train right now.
Yeah, me too.
Do you still think there are a lot of good action RPGs out there? We've got some really solid options. Do you think Diablo 3 is now, like with Loot 2.0, it is your go-to loot game for now and like for the foreseeable future or for forever? Like, is this it?
I feel like it's going to be the one I try to stick to. And I mean, there's a lot of good options out there. And like Neomar knows, you know, Torchlight 2 had me for my Diablo fix at first. And I kind of fell off of that as other games came out and never went back to it. But I don't think now that Loot 2.0 is out, Torchlight 2 wasn't really giving me like legendaries. And I don't know, I don't remember the setup of that game, how so it set, like, you know, how it hooked you in.
Its loot was somewhere in between Loot Diablo 3's original setting and Loot 2.0. It wasn't.
Yeah.
It was in the middle. Like they, I mean, there is something nice about being showered with all of the gear and all of the shiny things, but it wore off over time. And I think Torchlight 2 had a better balance, but not as good as what I've experienced in my half a dozen hours of the current Diablo.
Yeah. I've tried Path of Exile. I mean, that's another... That's a fun game, but I don't know. Everyone around me is like, oh, Path of Exile, you know, go to it. It's free to play. You know, it's everything I wanted out of Diablo 3. It's got a massive web of skills that blows your mind and sends you to the hospital. But I played it off and on, and I don't know if it... Something about maybe just looking at it, or I just can't get hooked by it.
Okay.
I don't know why.
It was weird. So Torchlight was my mindless loot game for the longest time. I tend to bounce back and forth between that and Borderlands, which can give me the same fix, honestly. And you can play Borderlands kind of mindlessly. Path of Exile was what I wanted out of the atmosphere of Diablo 3. Like, as far as it took itself a little bit more seriously than Diablo 3. Like, Diablo tries to, like, it's dark. It's got some dark content, but there's still something on the surface level that's a little bit friendlier to the audience. Like, you don't have to really get in that stuff. But Path of Exile is, that's a nasty world that you're dropped in. And I really liked it. And, you know, it's kind of got more of a hardcore skill progression and how you level up your character. And I got really into the RPG side of that. And but when it came down to the action, it was kind of on par with Diablo for me. So, but I found myself enjoying Path of Exile a lot more than I enjoyed Diablo 3 out of the gate. So I'm really curious to see when and if I cool on Diablo 3, if I go back to Path of Exile, because it's got its first expansion coming out as well. So that's, you know, I can only play one of these loot games at once.
Yeah, there's no way I can just jump from loot game to loot game.
So Diablo 3's got me for the next 4 to 6 weeks, but I don't know if it's got me for good. That's kind of my question, because there's just, I don't know, there's some competition out there. Like I said, I'm still going back through Borderlands. That always has new content to play through. And like I said, gives me the same fix. You know, I've heard, I still feel like I need to give Marvel Heroes another shot, because they have...
I saw Josh playing that.
Yeah, they've added a lot to it since I came around, and that has potential just because it'll feel completely different since it's superheroes. But Marvel Heroes still doesn't have my favorite thing about loot is you've got to see the loot on your character, and you just doesn't really have that impact.
There's no Spider-Man in special shiny pants.
Yeah. I mean,
that would sell me.
Let's see. Out of these games, I think I actually enjoy, as far as the aspect of putting the loot on your character, I think Torchlight 2 still does it the best. Like, I've seen some wicked Diablo 3 builds, but there's some awkward ones along the way.
And
I like the art style of Torchlight 2.
Me too.
I haven't seen the high level Path of Exile stuff though. But I need that. Like you said, like, once you get past the core gameplay of clicking on things and seeing them blow up, the loot is what's going to keep you coming back. And
yes.
So I need the first aspect I need is that I'm going to, you know, get some nice gear after, you know, a 1 to 2 hour session with the game, like two or three things that I'm excited about. But then also I've got to see the changes in my character and see that evolve over time. And, and Diablo was good at showing me the character progression, but I used to not get the loot, but now I'm starting to get stuff on me, the loot that I'm excited about. Has anybody got a count on the number of times we've said loot?
Loot, drink. That's what I like about Diablo, and I mean, other games do it well too, but especially with this experience buff that we've got, you know, the way my wizard looked when I finally came back to Diablo versus the way my wizard looks now is just drastically different. Like, I've got better equipment. Yeah, it hits harder. It's got better stats and better attributes to it. But, I mean, I started off looking like a traditional kind of wizard, and now I've got like gnarly shoulder pads and a lightning sword, and I'm like, this is ridiculous, but it works because this stuff is so awesome that I don't want to be like, oh, I should have a wand like I did before, and I should be holding, you know, this item. I'm like, I want the stuff that is badass, and I will use it regardless of how I think a wizard should traditionally, you know, look in a game like this.
Yeah, and yeah, it definitely didn't. It seemed like such a long tail before you got that in Diablo 3. And
yeah,
the grind is what that game's all about. But like I said, I got bored before I beat it on normal. So I'm hoping, to ignore the story and just keep going back for adventure mode and just getting more gear and enjoying co-op. Like when that stuff's out of my mind, when it's like I'm gonna just, if I can just not think about anything, clear the map, and then kind of look at my inventory and see nice new shiny things, and my character looks like a badass. By the end of that session, I'm happy to play with friends rather than trying to concentrate on every little drop, which was what I was doing, and it was taking some of the fun out of it.
Yeah, definitely. It's nice having that bag full of shiny goods, and then you can compare with your friends. And I mean, that's just something, I mean, I guess for me, maybe that's the rarity just because I kind of plowed through Diablo 3 the first time by myself, which some people would say, like, don't do that. But I don't know, for me, it was kind of fine. I just put, like, some TV on, you know, light a fire and play some slow jams and just kill Diablo. But actually playing with some people and them going, oh, I got this legendary, look at it. I'm like, oh, well, I got this legendary, look at it. And we're like, oh, shit.
Show you mine. Show me
I'll
yours.
Show you mine. You show me yours. Show me your orange.
Is there anything, like, I don't feel like Loot 2.0 is anything new. Like, I feel like they almost went back to the classic version of Loot.
Yeah.
And I just go through these phases where I actually had loot fatigue there after Borderlands and Darksiders 2, Torchlight 2, Diablo 3, and I know that that's a possibility, and so that's why I don't think Diablo 3 has solved anything. I think it's like I'm gonna finally get my money's worth out of it now, but I don't.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's fixed anything. And what do you think? What do you think the wall is that we keep hitting? Like, why do we put these games down versus being obsessed with the loot?
I think it's, for me anyway, I feel like it's a matter of fatigue. That, I mean, in Diablo 3 traditional, just welcomed the fatigue because your rewards were not coming as fast as they needed to. Mm-hmm. For like, for every 10 enemies you're clicking, your reward for it, you know, you had very little to show for it. You would approach a mob of enemies, destroy them, and they'd return the favor by saying, here's this crappy item that sells for 4 gold, and you can't use it because it sucks.
But hey, you might be able to buy one on the auction house.
But you can go to the auction house, and that's where all the good stuff is.
But that's, yeah, and for me, buying that stuff has never been satisfying. Like,
no.
Like, there was I enjoyed the auction house in World of Warcraft because I understood the progression to get there. Like, it was just, it was much more tied to the gameplay, like as far as how their crafting system worked, and it just things made sense, and
definitely,
I had a good sense of the economy. I just never got into that with Diablo 3. Like, I just didn't, I couldn't feel like how much closer am I really getting to these next items versus it's so much more satisfying when you kill that boss and it drops that legendary that changes your game. Like, in that's why I keep burning through content. I want to be excited to kill the next guy to see what he's going to drop. And you know, after two acts of Diablo originally, I kind of lost that feeling and forgot why I was even playing the game. So
Blizzard really messed it up with the auction house, and I mean, I kind of see what they were trying to do. They're like, hey, if you just want to spend the money and get the good stuff, here you go. But the idea of what these loot games are is that it's gambling, essentially. Mm-hmm. Is that you're going to put in all this time and all this effort for the chance that you might get something really good, but you also need the rewards. You need the breadcrumbs to get you to keep going for that chance to get something good. Mm-hmm. And when they're like, here's all the stuff in an auction house, you know, just buy it. You know, like, why did I pay money for a game to buy the things that will be good, and then I will use them for what purpose? To, you know, to buy more stuff to be good? I mean, it's it's kind of ludicrous, really, of
ludicrous.
of a gameplay strategy.
Oh, not loot.
And that's why, yeah, not luda.
Loot a Chris.
Ludicrous.
Never mind. My pun died a long time ago.
It's your pun died in loot 1.0. And now it's back. It's back and better.
I mean, I'm trying to think of what they could do. There needs to be like another reason to pursue the loot after you. I mean, I think adventure mode is a smart add, because it just kind of adds infinite content in that regard. It gives me gives me a reason to keep playing, but what can they do to? And the Paragon system's good. I'm trying to think of what the wall I hit is. There also becomes a point where you feel so overpowered that the game stops being fun. So there needs to be something along the lines that you basically level the game out, and you really have to, like, skill starts to become involved with unlocking the loot. Like, maybe you have to perform.
Are you, like, talking about challenges or achievements?
Yeah, I guess. No, I don't.
Like an end game kind of, how do you end game Diablo 3?
Yeah, because it can't be quests. It can't be like a daily quest system or an achievement. But it is almost like you have to perform 10 or 12 of these tasks to then get your chance at this next thing. I mean...
They could maybe do something like that.
Single-player raids. That's not right, but... How do you... I think skill has to come back into play at some point, because...
Those games are always tough to, I guess... As I was playing it over this past weekend, it's tough to describe, you know, what makes Diablo 3 challenging, because it always seems to be attrition, really, and that it's not, oh, I need to put myself... And maybe just from a single-player standpoint, it's not like, I need to watch this character and see what, you know, watch for the tells and see what attacks this enemy is going to pull on me. It's like, I reached a really strong character, and I'm just going to stand here, and I'm going to spam it and run. And that's kind of what I was doing. But it sounds like you're onto something.
Okay. So it's not quite hardcore mode, but I guess maybe it is.
Okay.
It's got to be something where you can lose the loot. I'm not even thinking about losing your life.
Oh, man.
For some people, losing the loot probably is the same thing. But there needs to be some sort of risk-reward when you pursue these elite quests or something that are a little bit more skill-based, that if you fail, you have to choose like an item to destroy, or it'll randomly choose.
That's devious.
Doing some sort of like gambling, like I'm going to bet this badass sword so I can get the next badass sword, but if I lose, I lose my badass sword, and that's not badass. It could be badass.
Huh. That's actually not as bad or scary of an idea as I thought. Yeah, it does motivate you to succeed rather than I'm going to throw myself in here, and if I fail, I'm going to take a little bit of a durability hit to my items, but I'm just going to go repair it because it only costs, you know, pocket change to do so. But yeah, the idea that if you have to wager your loot to get a chance to get better loot, or even just say you will guaranteed get loot of this fashion.
Yeah.
But its stats might be a little jumbled up, but it will be pretty damn good. Mm-hmm. That's actually, I find that kind of interesting of an idea. Like, and it makes me wish that Diablo 3 was maybe a little bit more experimental. Like, there are other games that will have, you know, like lab lobbies where they'll try things out. It would be nice to have a Diablo 3 where they're like, hey, we're going to try out this system and see if the community likes it. Because I think the idea you've proposed could be...
Because if you think about it, like, so I get bored with the gameplay pretty quick. Like, after you've got all your skills and you've got your 2 to 3 that you rely on, that you're crushing with, then it's all about the loot. And then at some point you've got, you know, awesome loot, and just a step above just isn't that big a deal. So you need to start taking the gameplay needs to come back, at a high interest level, and then I think you can kind of start the loop over again. Or give me... I've never felt a reason to have multiple builds. Like, I was reading that... I was reading that one of the downfalls of Diablo, the late game Diablo 3, is there's just, to beat the game, you need to have a certain build for your class. Like, there's no way around it. You need to search out certain weapons. And then maybe through this adventure system, it can, like, encourage, like, this is more of, like, I don't know, a ranged mission, or this is an adventure mode for two people, and you need to be complementary classes. But just like I said, bring back some more skill-based, like, strategical decisions that you have to be mindful of as you're playing, so you're thinking about something else other than loot, but you're risking loot along the way, and because that's what people value. So I don't really, you know, the hardcore mode about losing everything, that's one way to do it. But I think if you start just letting me, you know, you always lose your best piece of gear when you're making these bets for each of those challenges, that might be something. Okay.
Yeah, something like that. I mean, I don't know about the best piece of gear, but I definitely think the idea of having that loss in there of what seems to matter, which is the loot.
Maybe it's not your best piece of gear, but, like, the reward is based off of the gear that you're risking. So you would have to, like, you know, say it's a, for lack of a better term, a level 70 hat. Like, if you want to get a 72, you've got to put the 70 up. But if you've got a level 90 sword to get the 95, you'll have to put that one.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, yeah. So, yeah, it would, yeah, the idea of it being maybe your decision, like, I'm risking this particular thing for a chance at a better particular thing.
Ghost is kind of downplaying the monsters in Diablo 3 too. Like, yeah, I mean, I've never really, challenge is a problem in that game. Like, it, when it spikes, it's like you're being swarmed and it's almost unfair. Like,
definitely.
And I would love to see some skill. Like, there's gotta be some high level Diablo 3 play that could, like, I feel like when you're spending hundreds of hours with this game, it's got to teach you certain skills that you're only going to know after spending that much time, and reward those players, because those are the ones that are sticking with it on this for grinding to that level. So,
yeah.
You know, make that, yeah, something with the AI and the monsters has to change, or
there's a severe lack of the AI changing. I think you just attack enemies and eventually they will die, and there's, like, no strategy. Like, this enemy has a shield and you gotta destroy the shield, but if you just want to get straight to him, you can go behind him. Like, there's none of these kind of AI, you know, particulars that appear in other games.
So what we need is, now that Loot 2.0 is out and now that Dark Souls 2 is out, Blizzard needs to contract a few of the From Software designers and just kind of get their take. Like, what do you think the high level Diablo 3 play should be, and how can we bring some Dark Souls sensibility to our end game?
I would support that.
Because, yeah, just get some skill involved, and skill and risk will increase the value of that loot. So that's my idea anyway.
Which is funny, because I think Dark Souls is like the antithesis of what Diablo is. Like, there is loot in that game, but it's about the skill, and Diablo, vice versa.
Yeah, I mean, how many Dark Souls runs are based around having as little gear as possible, like that type of stuff. So, I think they could both learn something from one another. So I'm offering that exchange to Blizzard and From Software, like
symbiosis.
You know, I'm sure Dark Souls could use a little bit of Diablo in it too. So.
Yeah, Dark Souls 3 confirmed.
I'm glad we were able to concept that tonight. That was an unintentional bonus of this episode.
Yes,
I'm trying to think. Where do you think you're going after Diablo 3? Is there anything on the horizon?
In the same genre,
you can get your action RPG fix. Or no, like, what do you find yourself after you're done looting? Where do you like to go?
I like to go out to my beach house, sit on my lake at my beach house.
You play Diablo 3 by
candle, yeah, by fireplace light.
Fireplace, campfire light in your house.
I start a campfire. I burn all my furniture, and I play Diablo 3. I like to write poetry when I'm done with Diablo 3.
I still want to check out Grimdawn. I'll be really curious how that feels next to Path of Exile. And then I just saw that Incredible Adventures of Van Helsing 2 was announced.
So, everyone wanted it, so here it is.
That game was a victim of loot fatigue. That came out after Diablo 3 and Torchlight 2, and it's just like, I don't know if I need another one of these, and I also can't make Van Helsing look any different, but hopefully they learned some of their lessons there.
Cooler hats.
Yeah, I tend to find after my loot fatigue, I just like to shoot stuff, so maybe this will carry me through to Destiny, and then we'll come back around with something. I don't know if they'll do another. They probably won't do another Diablo expansion. So, you know what?
Not though? So soon.
The scary thing is this might actually lead me into the Warcraft expansion.
Oh no! Yeah, there is one. They're advertising it. That level 90 character boost.
Mm-hmm.
What does that even mean? I saw people saying bought that, if you could start a new character and immediately be level 90.
Today you could be level.
Today 90. You could be 90.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Because I played Warcraft for the loot. I played Warcraft for the loot and for the story. So, not end game loot by any means. But I got excited when I would find that epic weapon that I knew was out there. Like that game did a lot better with almost touting some of its gear. Like, you knew its name before you got it. Diablo is still very much, I don't know the name of any of this shit.
Yeah, so it makes no sense.
I'm just excited because it's the right color. So,
colors.
So yeah, if they could, maybe that's another route these loot games could do, is build up some of their, the more mystical weapons or their legendary weapons. And you're getting legendary weapons, but give me a story, the actual story around it, and build that up a little bit more. Maybe I'll care. So that would be the other route. If you don't go the skill route, go the, make me give a shit about the Diablo story. And that's a tall thing to ask. But since I like to shut my brain off.
Especially at this point.
Yeah. go back and retell the story. So
redo the story about how I got cool loot, and then I show it to Diablo, and he just surrenders immediately. And then I'll have to fight him for 30 minutes by myself.
I wonder how Diablo feels to lose all this loot.
I never thought about, where did the loot come from? Like, what if Diablo did make all the loot?
I mean, he's responsible for the loot economy. Whether he's not directly creating this stuff, but this stuff, this stuff exists in the world to fight him and his minions. Like, he is, he's responsible for this wartime economy.
He's a war criminal, right?
So did you beat Torchlight 2?
I have never beaten Torchlight 2, okay. And it wasn't until Nil and I played for a while, back when I used to stream that I got to Act 2 for the first time, and that's where I am at the beginning of Act 2.
Huh. I don't remember how far I got, because I play that game much like Borderlands 2. I just play it in spurts and never make any heavy. I mean, Diablo 3, I really thought I was going to finish it, but I don't know. You know, where Act 4 starts just kind of put me off. I was like, I don't even care anymore. And
it does get kind of just gratuitous at Act 4, and you're like, I gotta do stuff. It's leading to Diablo. I know it's gonna get there. It's taking forever. And then you get to Diablo, and I was like, kill me now.
But did you haven't played any Path of Exile?
I've played some, and I think I was using a thief of some sort. I think maybe that's what the game is, just kind
it's
of
tough to play solo.
Roast.
Yeah.
Thief was just a little.
It's a difficult. It's a punishing game, and but it's doing some. I think the whole bartering system is really interesting. And again,
it's got a lot of good points. Yeah.
And the setting is just. I mean, you start that game with nothing, so
you are just a naked, shipwrecked,
exile
little idiot. Exile, you were exiled on the path, and there's a bunch of crabs.
Why was Darksiders 2 loot system broken?
Darksiders 2 is that game that I thought I would finish and never did. But what the hell? That game had a weird loot system at a certain point, and I can't remember why.
Well, it had the whole possessed
loot
weapons.
Eat other loot?
Yeah, loot. Yeah. Eat loot.
Loot ate loot.
But at some point, the loot stopped being interesting.
There's a real tailspin. Not the Disney cartoon, but there's a real
Baloo the bear.
Baloo Kit. There's a real tailspin in terms of me knowing what I should do with the loot I was getting in that game. I'm like, this one's kind of better because it ate other loot, but this is the new thing. And then they gave me pre-order DLC or something, which is this loot, but I don't know if that's good anymore because that loot's full up on other loot. And I'm like, I don't know, And then I kind of just, I think it tired me out and I haven't played it since.
Yeah, it just, and then I felt like I maxed out the loot pretty, like, with plenty of the game to go. It just, the loot stopped being interesting. And if your loot is not interesting, don't do a loot system. Do meaningful weapons and skill upgrades and that kind of stuff. And it was, that game bit off more game systems than it could chew on for sure.
They really wanted to give it a hook that was different than... They really wanted to make death different than war, and are like, oh, so death's faster, he's got all this loot, and it's possessed and eating each other, and the weird thing about it is I didn't feel like I hated that game, but I stopped playing it, and sometimes I look at it, and I'm like, I don't know. I don't know when I'll play it again. And now that developer is no more or something. I don't know.
Yeah, I mean... The guys that bought it want to keep doing stuff with the franchise, but I was like, there was some vision here that obviously they had to give up on halfway through Darksiders 2, so, you know, and if it's all going towards a four-player co-op game where you're all the horsemen, you know. Actually, that game could be all right Diablo style. Like if they,
yeah, I was just thinking, we were talking about loot.
Yeah,
make like that an action RPG. And
I mean, I liked it for being a third-person action game, but it... I could actually, I would play that if it just went all Diablo.
I think I would too.
Yeah.
I would have to finish Darksiders 2 or read a wiki. I don't know.
Did I make you slightly interested in the Warcraft expansion?
Are
you
playing? No.
Oh, damn it.
I put in my time. I was a panda. I'm done. It's over.
But don't you be, no, I don't think they're redoing the panda models. I was gonna say, don't you want to be a better looking panda? But
they're redoing the original the models. Of original. Okay,
yeah.
Better looking humans.
The humans are never good looking.
They're always ugly unless they give them like
the
hair physics.
In World of Warcraft, are assholes. They are just
they are the worst.
They are terrible. That's why you shouldn't play Alliance because they're all uppity.
Yeah, Alliance in general. I don't know. I liked my gnome or whatever for a while.
I still don't understand why the Wargren, is that how you say that? Why they're on the Alliance? But that's a topic for another day that only I care about.
Balance, terrible balance.
Have you ordered Reaper of Souls?
I have not, which is I don't really know I should feel compelled to. I mean, I will play. I think I will get and play Reaper of Souls. At first, I said no, and now I'm betting on it. But I don't see why I should pay them now.
Because I will have Reaper of Souls gear that you do not have that you will be jealous of. That's why you should get the game.
That's why I should order it now.
Yep.
What gear? Is it gear? Oh, wait. Is it gear in Diablo? I thought there was gear.
I'm assuming there is gear in Act 5 in Adventure Mode that you will not be able to get.
That's bullshit.
I could be wrong. RuneScape.
I'll have to look.
We should have talked about RuneScape. That's one of the OG.
I refuse
to
indulge. Neil doesn't like me talking about Spelunky. And I don't like him talking about RuneScape.
Get him. So,
some bitch.
What about Marvel Heroes? Should we try it?
No.
Okay. It really does put me off. Like, I understand you don't. These are superheroes that have a defined look. You don't go changing their clothes all the time. But that's a big aspect for me. It's like I want to see my shiny gear when I put it. Like I want to be able to dye my shiny gear, make it look different. I want to be able to make it invisible if I want to make it invisible, and then I also want it to look awesome on me. And they don't let you do that in Marvel Heroes. And
are there alternate costumes?
There's gotta be. You probably have to pay.
There's
for
gotta
it.
Be. That's money. I mean, they'll charge you $80 for a character kit or something. There's gotta be alternate costumes.
Yeah. But yeah, that it then it became okay. I'm not getting that aspect. the loot's not all that interesting, and there are so many like other better games to play in this genre now. Like once you know, Torchlight 2 was that budget game for a while, but when Path of Exile showed up free to play, and then I'm hearing good things about Grim Dawn that's also out there. Like, I've got four other games to play. Granted, they're all, you know, they still all have those little the fantasy aspects of it. So I think there's still room for, you know, a science fiction or a different take on this genre. But I don't think superheroes is it for me.
I don't know. Superheroes, it's just kind of, they're riding a wave of being relevant. Not that I feel like superheroes aren't ever relevant, but they're like especially out there with movies making them just kind of a fan favorite, the popular summer thing to do. But I would rather play, I'd like to see a nice, you know, sci-fi action RPG where your weapons aren't swords and maces, but you're seeing some interesting things and just way out there concepts. But I don't know of that game at the moment.
Yeah. That's it for this episode of The Cursed Checkpoint. We'll be back again with another topic real soon. Let us know what you thought about our loot discussion, and we'll continue it at a future date, I'm sure. But Aaron, thanks for hanging out.
I'm going to go play.
And me too. We'll see you guys next time.
See ya.